Hey guys, today we're going to talk about the hair transplant forum scam revealed. This is something I only recently learned, but I kind of experienced when I was first interested in getting a hair transplant. I did exactly what probably most of you guys are doing, which is going on all these different forums. We're not going to name any here, podcasts, blogs, and I was seeing a lot of the same surgeons come up over and over and over again. And then I would talk to people that I knew who had gotten hair transplants, and they would mention their doctor, and I would search for them on those blogs and forums, and I wouldn't find them mentioned. And it kind of confused me over, okay, is this person good, but they're not being mentioned on these forums, and I think all the top doctors are on these forums, so who do I really choose? So Steve recently revealed the truth as someone who is in the hair transplant industry, and he's going to talk about that today.
Yeah, well, you know, I get a lot of calls and I always answer my phone. I get a lot of texts, a lot of emails, thank you very much. And recently was talking to a patient, I think it was up in the greater Northwest, and I referred the patient to a few doctors to take a look at. So he went out and did his due diligence. This guy's very articulate, and he came back and said, you know, I'm happy with the information and I'm looking at a few doctors. I have a few more questions for you, but I do have a question that's kind of out of curiosity. I've been on these hair transplant forums, some blogs, there's different ones out there, and the two doctors that you recommended were not mentioned anywhere inside of these, you know, blogs or interactive kind of forum things, and I'm curious as to why. And, you know, I pointed out, I said, these hair transplant, you know, forums, blogs, podcasts, all these different things are great sources, great resources for information, but they are paid advertising sites. Now, you can go on your own and look and research. It's going to take you a while. But if you look at what's the document as physician selection standards, it's going to take you to another page and another page, and you're going to see that every single doctor that's highly regarded on these different sites pay a membership fee. Mm-hmm. More than that is that they backlink to all the doctors' websites. So what's interesting to me is when you Google certain major keywords like the word hair transplant or hair transplants, these forums will pop up number one or number two, and they've been doing that for about 12 to 15 years now. That's not easy based on Google's algorithms. It's because there's so much back and forth between all the different doctors. So if you're a new doctor, you've just broken into hair transplants, you don't really know too much about business, and you sign up for one of these blogs, they start recommending you. And that gets you a lot of business right away. Then you're back linked in, and then you're kind of coming up on the search engines. So we're not saying, I'm not saying that these doctors that are recommended on these sites are bad doctors or poor choices. As a matter of fact, a lot of the top doctors that I do recommend are on these sites. But we just want to even the playing field and let you, the consumer, understand what's going on. When you go on, you post and say, hey, who do you like in Seattle? And you're given a doctor, well, guess what? That doctor has paid for that. So just keep that in mind and just keep your questions coming. I'd love to help you.
And so when these doctors, when someone who joins this site mentions a doctor who's not a doctor that's paying to be on this site, what happens to the mention?
Well, what used to happen is they would kind of say a lot of bad things. And I think there were some lawsuits thrown around and it was kind of got dicey, and then they backed off from that. But what the problem that I have is there's people on there blogging, there's people on there that have joined as a member that, you know, you may think is just another person, another guy out there that's kind of doing some research. You guys are all sharing information. Meanwhile, this guy, he's being paid to recommend a doctor to you in your area. And to me, that's unfair. That needs to be disclosed. Now, they're going to say it is disclosed, but good luck trying to find that.
Yeah, so just a few minutes ago, Steve decided to show me. He was like, hey, so let me show you exactly on one of these sites where the disclosure is. And even Steve and I looking for it, I mean, we knew it was there. We knew it had to be there. But even us looking for it, it took like, what, 10 minutes of us scouring the site, and in this tiny, tiny little print at the bottom of like a page that you wouldn't even expect it to be on, it had a disclosure that everyone who was featured on there was a paying member of the site. So, I mean, good luck trying to even find that link. So as Steve mentioned, we just want to really even the playing field that just because someone isn't mentioned on one of these blogs or podcasts or sites, it doesn't mean that they're not a good doctor. And at the same time, as Steve said, It doesn't mean that the people who are on those sites aren't good doctors. Most of the people that are on those sites are good surgeons. So we're not saying if someone's on this site, don't go to them. We're just saying that across the board, I think it's very important that you understand both sides of what's going on here.